Hi everybody, welcome back to my channel. This is Vanquished Angel, and today we're going to be looking at Vector Linux. Vector Linux is based off of Slackware. So, Vector. Well, you know what, we're just going to stick with that. Over 8 gigs of memory. And I try to give them all over 30, I guess. I'll just go with what it goes. And vector. Open. Start. Well, I kind of like that installer there. That was really straightforward. I kind of like that. So. Welcome to the Vector Linux installer. Select one. I imagine that's supposed to say the following installation methods. The automatic option will let you pick a disk to install Vector in, and we will take it from there. Well, I like easy. I'll capture. Yes. Username, Vanquished Angel. And put my password in, and then admin password. And forward. I'm liking this install process here. Hopefully that goes away soon, because that makes me nervous. And I like the opening splash screen, that's for sure. And it seems to be taking a while to boot up, but that's alright. It can be old, I don't care. Ooh. See, now that's kind of fun. Pigeon. Minimize all. Terminal. Alright, so let's take a look and see what we got here. We got a menu system. I like the menu system. I'm just a fan of it. But I like that it doesn't force the bar on you. You have the choice of a bar or the menu system. A lot of them force their own on you. So, let's take a look. All. Oh, we can go through all. So we have Abbey Ward. And they're in alphabetical order. And it uses XFCE, I see. Adobe Flash Player. We can customize the appearance. Application Finder. Oh, that's basically like the start menu there. Accessibility, Application Finder, Audio Mixer, Brazero Disk Burner, Bulk Rename, so you can rename files, Disk Utility, that's probably the generic Disk Utility that's in Ubuntu, that's what it looks like. Yeah, it is. So for this one, almost appears to give a little bit more information. And then configure displays, the document viewer, exhale. That looks like a music player. Yeah. So there's that. I've never used it, so I don't really know. I just prefer to use one application for everything. Firefox is the web browser. That looks like GUFW. It is. Sorry, I got the hiccups a little bit. Alright, and then GNOME mPlayer. That's what I use. Gkey. Glade. Gnumeric. Grip. CD Ripper. G-slapped Package Manager. I've never used it. HTOP. Let's see. The RAM is really, really good. CPU is really good. This has got to be one of the lightest distros I've ever tested. I mean, other than Puppy Linux, but even that would give it a run for its money. And this one's fully featured. Also, it's Puppy, but... And anyway... JPilot, desktop organizer. Let's see. So there's notifications. You can organize how they appear. Pigeon Instant Messenger. I use Pigeon. SM Player, I use that too. So we got a little bit of redundancy in the terms of that. Thunar File Manager. Let's see what the web browser is. I think it has Firefox. I think we covered that before. Yeah. It's Firefox. Take a screenshot. Same for image scanning. Archiver. Claws Mail is your email. Claws is, or Silphied is forked from Claws, so. And Tux cards. Alright. So it's very fully featured. I really like it. That dock is interesting. Quick volume control. Take a screenshot. And application finder and Pigeon. There's not a whole lot to say about it. It's quick, it's slick, it's efficient, it looks good too. So we're gonna go cancel desktop settings maybe. You get a choice of different wallpapers, though I really like the one that it has. That one. Oh, my mushrooms won. I had that wallpaper years ago, and I don't even use Vector. Never used Vector before. Alright, this one's definitely a contender for me to switch to. I was debating on not switching for a long time, but this one definitely is a contender for that. Just because of how lightweight and really intuitive that it actually is. And I love this menu system. That's probably part of like Mate or whatever the menu system they have here is. I'm seeing this a lot in a lot of them, this specific setup. And then you set your applications. So, File Manager. Huh. There we go. All right, I really am liking Vector Linux now. This is one of my favorites that I've looked at so far. Let's look for Synaptic. It doesn't have that, so maybe it has its own package. Pancake. G-slapped, that's right. So let's take a look at G-slapped and see what's in there. And I might have gotten the password wrong. Oh, that's different. I've seen this before, though. I don't know if they're an LMNOPQRSA. Okay, so they're not... They're in alphabetical order, but a little different. So what about wine? It might need to be updated. So we're going to update it and see if it finds anything. Okay, so now there's... That looks familiar. I've used Pipelate before. But the interesting part is, why is Pipelate available but not wine? Not finding wine in here. Just Pipelate. Maybe if I installed it, or maybe there's something that I have to... Oh, there's some sources. And you can use FreeBSD? That's interesting. The Slackware sources? Okay, so it's probably just not in the sources, but it's available. That's probably why that's there. Wouldn't make sense to have Pipelate without anything else. Okay, so this is a look at Vector Linux. It's definitely a contender for me to install. I'm not sure. There we are. That's... What's this? Let's switch users, lock screen, all settings. And we're going to shut down. All right. Thank you for watching. And as always, have a wonderful day. If you like the video, please give a like, leave a comment, and subscribe to my channel. All right. Bye.